Aloha mai kākou, a kama mai te curtain call from a distance, a program of reviews, previews, interviews, and features of and or with the great art and artists on Maui and beyond. I'm Paul James Brown, and I'm coming to you from my home office, where I have been conscientiously practicing self-isolation. After an auspicious world premiere at the Hawaii International Film Festival, the Maui movie Aloha Surf Hotel opened its theatrical run very successfully at the Regency Cinema in Kihei. Members of the cast, the writer, director, and producers were all on hand to greet the audience, and there was even the opportunity to get a photo in front of an Aloha Surf Hotel backdrop. Here is the trailer for the film.
You know, I don't know what happened to Ty. One day he was riding the biggest waves, he was winning world championships, he was on the cover of magazines, and then he sort of disappeared.
We just hired the best instructor on the island. I mean, you probably have heard of him. Ty Alonso? Gonzo Alonso.
Hey, that's my band! That's where I live! Wait! How's your flight?
Good, good. So what, you actually have a job now?
Yeah, surf instructor, but, you know, you got me doing everything over here. Let's warm up nice and slow. What you're gonna do is you're gonna put yourself into a tight ball.
Hey, no pigs in the water! Come on, big boy, get up! There you go!
I haven't had my shot yet. I want to go pro, but to do that, I have to have a coach.
Your coach is right here. I've been doing this for a long time.
Okay, here's the deal. The hotel might get foreclosed on if we don't get shut down by the county first.
The county? I've heard that before, bro. All them guys, they're all taking bribes. This is not gonna be like Waikiki.
So what are you gonna do about it, Dad?
$5,000 or 1 year in prison.
Some big developer will come, tear this place down, and put up a big resort.
And you're just gonna sit here and stuff your face?
You gotta fight for this place.
Yeah, Dougie, you ain't gonna come.
I already caught him.
No guidance up here. Only suffering. No guidance. No guidance.
When you're down in a surf competition, did you just paddle in or throw in the towel?
No, I never owned a towel.
The movie is about a former champion surfer, Ty Gonzo Alonso, Augie T. Tulba, who has been attending college for nearly two decades on a scholarship. Dean Hammer, Lauren Shaw, newly arrived from the mainland and complete with navy blue power suit, tells Gonzo his scholarship is canceled and he can no longer attend university. His van gets towed away for overtime parking, like for 6 years, and he has to get a job to get his van, which is also his home, back from the impound yard. Because of his previous fame, he is hired as a surf instructor at the Malu Hai'i Cottages, a place where we are told Hawaiian royalty stayed prior to missionary times. It is run by Mr. K, Branscombe Richmond, who is down on his luck and, due to county fines, is facing the loss of the place that has been in his family for generations. Suffice to say, Gonzo is really so gone, he is incapable of successfully doing much of anything, including maintaining child support payments for his lovely daughter, Alana, Kealani Warner, who many may remember from her role in Kuleana, now called Maui. We soon discover there is more to the closing of the cottages than meets the eye, and of course, evil, avaricious developers are afoot and abroad. Will the cottages fall into the clutches of the developers? Will Gonzo ever see his daughter again? Will he get his van back? Will Kailani enter the surfing championships? Who will Julie seduce next? You'll find the answer to these and other questions when you go see the film. Aloha Surf Hotel is a fun, family-friendly film that demonstrates to the world Maui's ability to make movies. It looks great, especially the surfing and ocean shots. We know all the characters, and the entire cast is doing their best. Augie T, as he is professionally known, in his first lead role, creates a great schlub, and he has genuine moments where he's facing real challenges. His Gonzo is exceptionally enthusiastic and throws himself, at times literally, into every scene, and he is in almost all of them. He loves to be the clown, and this movie was made for his talents, and I loved his surfer philosophy that turns out maybe comes from Laird Hamilton. Branscombe Richmond, as Mr. K, is officious while not being overbearing. In fact, his tolerance of Gonzo's incompetence is the definition of Christian forgiveness. He's like the captain on the Titanic, calmly directing his crew to save the passengers. As the baby mooners, Danielle Monet and Andrew Garner, bring a level of tolerance to their roles that borders somewhere between sainthood and martyrdom. Ms. Shaw, who makes her living as a stunt person and double, according to her IMDb bio, makes her feature debut with this film, and she might want to consider going for more. Her Dean Hammer makes a nice transformation as the Maui magic and Aloha spirit obviously spin their enchantment on her. As Doug, the frustrated weatherman who would rather be an investigative reporter, Matt Corby is like an anti-Hardy to Mr. Tulba's Laurel, or anti-Abbott to Mr. Tulba's Costello. He matches Mr. Tulba in both enthusiasm and energy. His cameraman in the latter part of the film is especially passionate. One of the antagonists and the cottage's yoga instructor, Shiv Andranda, Alex Farnham, creates a very over-the-top character who is perfectly suited to who this guy is, phony from here to there. His voice and lisping pronunciation are particularly creative, and his bondage scene is the only one that parents may find uncomfortable for the keiki, but it is so subtle, it will probably go over their heads. Kealani Warner as Alana continues her ascendancy as a rising young actor. With this performance, she shows compassion, caring, and depth. I look forward to her next foray onto the big screen. She has a real future in this business. Danielle DeLaunay as the on-the-make cougar Julie nearly steals the movie. Her attempted seduction of Gonzo is acting at its best, and her dominatrix with Aloha is a character we have not seen before. Bravo, Ms. DeLaunay. As her daughter, Maya, Talei Laury-Schaefer has some excellent moments as a young surfer, and her scene with Ms. Warner is quite touching. She also happens to be Mr. Schaefer's daughter. But while Mr. Tulba is the star of this film, the most grounded performance is turned in by Taiana Tully. Ms. Tully's Kayla is smart, committed, and clear in every scene, and she is entirely believable as the one who is keeping the cottages rolling along. Let's talk about the attack pig at Shelton's Auto Impound, played with brio by Pe'ahi the Pig. And then there was its surf double, played by Lily Coy. I have to give a shout out to Alicia Yamada, who was Ms. Tully's surf double. Her surfing scenes are radical, and she totally shreds all the way. In fact, all of the surfing scenes in this film are spectacular. Credit for them go to Three Tree Creative, John Spencer, Mike Latronic, and Manulele Media. Also, the young kite surfers put on quite a display. They are Cyrus Laury-Schaefer, Kyle Calmanson, and Tim Walsh. Notable cameos in this film come from Kai Lenny, the ubiquitous Kathy Collins, and the artist radio personality Frank B. Shaner. Finally, if it takes a village to make a child, then it takes an island to make a movie. The mahalas for building this project are extensive and far-reaching. When you read the credits, I guarantee you will recognize many friends. Congratulations to Stefan Schaefer for bringing this beautiful, fun gift to Maui for the holiday season. And congratulations to the entire cast and crew for making it happen. For a fun time at the cinema, go and check it out. Well, that's Curtain Call from a Distance for this week. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Paul James Brown. Ahui ho.